Dear students, in the last section we have seen characteristics of virtualization environment. In this section we will see taxonomy of virtualization techniques. So taxonomy means classification of the virtualization techniques. Virtualization covers a wide range of emulation techniques. So a classification of this virtualization techniques, it is better to understand the characteristics and use. So the first classification against the service or the entity that is being emulated. So first classification is according to the execution environment, according to the storage, according to the network. So among these three, execution virtualization is the oldest and most popular and most developed area. So therefore it deserves a major investigation and further categorization. So this execution environment is categorized as process level and system level. So we can divide this execution virtualization techniques into two major categories by considering the type of host they require. So there are two categories, that is process level and system level. Process level techniques are implemented at the top of the existing operating system, which has full control of the hardware, and system level techniques are implemented directly on the hardware or do not require or require minimum support from the existing operating system. So next is execution virtualization. Since this execution virtualization includes those techniques whose aim is to emulate an execution environment. So all these techniques concentrate their interest on providing the support for execution of the program. So that program may be operating system or binary specification of the program which is compiled. Okay, so this execution virtualization can be implemented directly on the top of the hardware by the operating system or by the application. So for that purpose it requires the machine reference model. So this is the machine reference model. So virtualizing an execution environment at different levels of the computing stack requires a reference model, and it is necessary that it is that a clear separation between the layers simplifies the implementation, which only requires the emulation of the interfaces. So it is necessary to separate the layers. So this is the reference model which is used is the modern computing system. So at the bottom layer there is a ISA, that is instruction set architecture. So it defines the instruction set for the processor, registers, memory and interrupt management. So ISA is the interface between the hardware and the software. Then next is the ABI, that is application binary interface, which is the interface between the operating system and the application as well as libraries. This ABI separates the operating system from the application and library. This ABI covers details such as low level data types, alignment and call conventions. The interface allows portability of the application and libraries, and system calls are defined at that ABI level. And the last level is API, that is application program interface, which interfaces application to libraries or to the underlying operating system. So if any operation is to be performed, then all these API, ABI and ISA are responsible to make it happen. The high level abstraction is converted into machine level instruction to perform the actual task. As we know, we are writing our program in the high level language, and it is converted into machine language because computer can only understand the machine language. So that is why here the high level abstraction is converted into machine level abstractions. So for this purpose, the instructions of the instruction set exposed by the hardware is divided into two different classes, and that classes are privileged instructions and non-privileged instructions. So non-privileged instruction means that instruction that can be used without interfering with other tasks because they do not access the shared resources. For example, the non-privileged instructions are arithmetic instruction, floating and fixed point instruction, and second is privileged instructions. So these privileged instructions are executed under the specific restrictions and are mostly used for the sensitive operations, which expose the behavior sensitive or control sensitive privilege state. Behavioral sensitive means it operate on the I/O, input and output devices, and control sensitive means it alter the state of the CPU registers. Okay. In the next section, we will see hardware level virtualization. Thank you.